Hey everyone, it's Alex from Footprint Analytics. I hope everyone is having a nice day. I know we are over here at Footprint. Today, we're going to cover some GameFi tokenomics in our video, specifically how tokenomics work that only have a single token. In case you don't know what GameFi is, it's the combination of decentralized finance and blockchain gaming. GameFi makes it possible to actually own your in-game assets, which currently doesn't exist in traditional gaming. So, what is tokenomics? Tokenomics is the structure of a project's economics and value system. At its core, tokenomics governs the relationship between NFTs and tokens. The tokenomics are what's responsible for creating the rewards you receive in GameFi. These economics and analysis for this presentation are researched through our GameFi dashboards here at Footprint Analytics. Specifically, our overview of GameFi chains, active users compared to new users, as well as our overview analysis of tokens mint and burn and holders. The links to these dashboards will be in our description. Our presentation today is separated into three parts. Games that use single token economics, the three tokenomic models games with one token use, and the performance of players in different modes of games. So, what is a single token game? Single token tokenomics was the first model adopted when GameFi was introduced. Some examples of these types of games are My DeFi Pet, Valkyrio, and Radio Kaka, or Raka. Each type of tokenomic model has its own submodels. So to make things simple, we're starting with the oldest and most basic. Although it's not as popular, there still are new projects that use only one token. So understanding it is still relevant in its own right. As the name suggests, single token GameFi projects have one token that supports all economic roles. Let's go over the three tokenomic models for games with one token only. GameFi games that utilize a single token model require a constant stream of new players to enter or repeat investment from existing users to achieve 100% external circulation. As you can see from the model, Gamer Alex buys a game's NFT, which yields the game's token. From there, I can choose to hold the token or sell for another more diverse cryptocurrency, such as USDT. Here's the three tokenomic models for single token games. Model A, where you input USD and output game token. Model B, input USD and output USD value based. And Model C, input game token, output game token. We'll go more in depth in the coming slides. Model A, input USD and output game token. This model was common at the beginning of the GameFi boom in 2021. In which users use USDT or Tether or BNB, Binance Coin, to buy NFTs and play to earn in-game tokens. This method is also widely adopted in the DeFi yield farming. This feature of this model is that the entry price is fixed and the earnings fluctuate with the token price. The payback period will decrease as the token price rises, and if the token is in an upward trend. This model can create a strong FOMO effect, or fear of missing out, once a positive spiral starts around the project. However, it also amplifies the output and consumption of the tokens, causing an irreversible death spiral. Once the token reaches a downward trend, a rug pull will happen in a degen project, while a solid project has to keep using real money to support the market and release good news to attract new players. It's a good tip to know that most rug pull projects love to use this model. So be sure to do your own research to determine if the project is worth investing in or not. My DeFi Pet is an example of a project that utilizes this model. Model B, input USD and output USD pegged token. To counteract the inevitable fall of the token price in Model A, a more recent type of game emerged where the token is always tied to USD value. For example, if the game is assumed to yield 100 USDT a day, the number of tokens will change according to the token price. If the token price is 1 USDT today, the player gets 100 tokens. If the token price becomes half USDT tomorrow, the player receives 200 tokens. This model enables fixed costs and returns for players. But is it too good to be true? Model B generally sets up a lockup period. The token price after 7 days may not be half a USDT. GameFi projects under this model tend to resist sudden surges and plunges. This means income is stable and the projects have longer lifespans. Valkyrio is a typical Model B project. Model C, input game token and output game token. In projects with Model C tokenomics, the cost and returns are both highly correlated to the token price. For example, a game requires 100 tokens to play and provides a return of 10 tokens per day. The cost and returns will fluctuate from 100 USDT and 10 USDT to 200 USDT and 20 USDT if the token price grows from 1 USDT to 2 USDT. As more players join, the prices surge, starting a FOMO cycle. Early players benefit from the dividends of rising token prices and draw revenue from the high cost of new players. Many projects that apply this model make a fortune overnight. Token prices are prone to spikes and drops. These type of projects have a short lifespan unless they can retain a large user base. Radio Kaka is a project that utilizes this tokenomics model. In summary, it is important to know about the tokenomics of a single token GameFi games. Realizing how a project rewards its players through these three models not only helps you get more insightful information to find promising projects, and also potential rug pull or degen projects. It's crucial to remember that each tokenomics model has its own distinct traits and dangers, so always do your own research before jumping into any project investment. So that's everything about GameFi tokenomics that utilize a single token. I hope you guys watching learned something new today, and if you liked the video, please be sure to like and subscribe. And leave a comment about your favorite tokenomic model we talked about today. And be sure to follow our Twitter and join our Discord for all our dashboard and AMA updates. The links will be in the description. And again, everybody, thanks for watching.